Do you know what liquid-liquid equilibrium is?
Hi everyone, this is Albert again. Thanks to our previous videos, I now understand how the mixtures behave. However, I'm still curious to know whether they are all the same. Gasoline, for instance, what would happen if we add another component to it?
Hi Albert, let me help you with that. Well, this of course depends on the type of component. If you add another hydrocarbon, the effect is the same. However, if you add water, you will find non-ideal behavior.
Wow, that's strange to me. I understand that hydrocarbons mixtures will behave in an ideal way. However, what do you mean by non-ideality?
Well, it's really easy to explain when you look at the atomic structure of the molecule. As you know, molecules are clusters of atoms. Since all atoms don't attract their electrons in the same way, the electron clouds surrounding the molecules may have many different shapes. For example, look at water. We know it's composed of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. The oxygen atom has a very strong attraction for the electrons, while the hydrogen atom tends to lose them. As a result, one side of the water, here drawn in blue, will become highly negative charged. Electrons are negative, while the other side, the hydrogen, will become positively charged. Hence, water is a very strong dipole. You can say it's polar. On the opposite, carbon, which is, with hydrogen, the backbone of all organic molecules, doesn't attract electrons much. This is why all hydrocarbons have a very smooth and electrically neutral surface. Here, we have a molecule which is nonpolar. And like this, we have molecules that are polar, nonpolar, polar, nonpolar. So considering this, you can say that if you mix molecules of the same kind, same polarity, they behave as ideal mixtures. However, if you mix molecules of very different type, you will find a strongly non-ideal behavior. Let's take for example that you add water to your gasoline. Have you ever tried this?
No.
Have you ever made a vinaigrette?
Yes, of course.
And did you notice there that you have two liquids that don't mix?
Yes, but what's your point?
Well, in a vinaigrette, you mix an oil, whose structure resembles gasoline, it's nonpolar, and vinegar, which contains a large amount of water.
I see, but how do you explain that they don't mix?
Well, before starting to explain this phenomenon, you must understand the difference between the two fluids' behavior. On one hand, the hydrocarbons are oils. Their motto is harmony and beauty. They feel good together because they don't harm each other. No strong attraction or repulsion is observed. This is because of its atomic structure. On the other hand, you have strongly interactive molecules resulting from their polar bonds, also called hydrogen bonds. Since different charges, positive and negative, attract each other strongly, the hydrogen, which has lost all its electrons, will therefore bind with any negative surface surrounding it. Their motto is "Together we are strong."
Wow, that's so interesting. Is there anything else to know about oil and water molecular behavior?
Here, we can see how water molecules have a particular atomic composition, which creates a physical attraction between molecules because of intermolecular force caused by the hydrogen bonds. On the other hand, we have oil molecules, which have only carbon and hydrogen in their backbone. Since they have neither positive nor negative sides, they are electrically neutral or nonpolar.
Yes, but I still don't understand why they don't mix.
Together we are strong, won't let harmony and beauty disturb their togetherness.
Aha, I get it. So we cannot mix oil and water because we're mixing a polar component with a nonpolar one. Is that right?
Exactly. The polar water forms a network that's very stable with its hydrogen bonds. Oil, gasoline, is like a light oil, don't fit into this network. It will become liquid, but will not want to mix. That's why you can mix water with gasoline or oil. These mixtures are called non-ideals.
Oh, that's so interesting. And to come back to the non-ideality concept, whenever we mix hydrocarbons, we will have an ideal mixture. But if we mix hydrocarbons with water or any other polar component, we will have a non-ideal mixture.
Well, in fact, there is a range of stickiness. As you can see in the following spectrum, some molecules have a highly energetic bond. Here, water, another less. In our case, hydrocarbons. And you have all kinds of intermediates in between. This leads to blends that mix more or less well. Mixtures that are more or less ideal.
What? A range of stickiness? Do you mean that there are components that can mix both gasoline and water?
Yes. A very good example is ethanol.
Ethanol? Do you mean the alcohol that makes the wine so tasty?
Mm-hmm. Its molecular structure is halfway between that of water and hydrocarbons, so it will mix with both components entirely. That's why fermentation can produce biogasoline, but let's keep that for another video.